We're going to move on now to the breaking news this morning. A new missile launch in North Korea just hours ago.
We are continuing to gather more information as we're on the air this morning, but North Korea seemingly speeding up its development of nuclear weapons and missiles. And following the story this morning, our Gloria Riviera, who's in our Washington bureau. Good morning, Gloria.
Good morning, Paula. That's right. This morning, another provocative move from North Korea. The country conducting its eighth missile test this year, just hours ago, from a site in the western part of the country. South Korea's military is reporting the unidentified projectile flew about 310 miles, coming down in the Sea of Japan. Both South Korea and the U.S. are currently analyzing this launch for further details. But this latest move comes just 1 week after North Korea successfully launched a KN-17 missile. That feat was celebrated with a massive parade May 19th, staged to hail missile developers as national heroes. That missile was seen as a success for the height it reached, an altitude of over 1,200 miles, as well as the distance, traveling about 435 miles before it too came down in the Sea of Japan. That altitude is seen as evidence North Korea is making progress on its missile program's long-range capabilities and possibly testing re-entry technology. In a statement, the White House indicated it does not believe this latest rocket to be another KN-17, but a shorter-range missile. Despite calls to stop, North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un persists. President Trump has suggested tougher sanctions. Last week, the UN called again for an immediate halt. But today, South Korea's new president, Moon Jae-in, is convening an emergency meeting in response to all of this. We'll be watching. Dan, Paula?
We certainly will be watching. Gloria, thanks for your reporting.